Welcome back to What Are Teen Noobs for General Disturbance. This is a 105 LetFH 18B2, the French Tier 5 Premium SPG, known as Fifi La Pew Pew, or a Leaf Blower, or Leffy, or Leffa. This one is on the north spawn of Kharkov and is under the command of Zephyr. Now, he hasn't moved away from the spawn point. He's actually sitting still and he's looking for any trace of the enemy. He's gone to battle assistant. Now, more than likely, a tank destroyer will go up onto the heights here, or a light tank. In fact, we've got a light tank coming straight across the battlefield at the moment. It's an ELC. Oh, that was a near one. Wasn't fully dialed in. It was a bit of a snapshot, but it was very close to the target. And it looks like the ELC is trying to get into that bush. No. Decided not to. I think he may have seen the shells landing, and he's found the target. It's an AMX 12 ton, and well, Zephyr almost got a kill there on the ALC, but the 12 ton got there before him. Over on the other side of the battlefield, we've got a T-52. He fired a snapshot in at him and missed. Now, a bit further down, we've got a KV-1S near the trench system. Now, again, he fired a snapshot and missed the target. I say fully dial your aim in before you shoot, that way you might get a hit. Like that. That's good. And he's going to dive into the trench, going after the Leopard. Rounds out. Lovely direct hit. The KV-1S is a one shot. The Leopard will probably take the kill. And he does. KV-85. And another lovely hit from Zephyr. 152 out of that one. It's a 105mm gun with 410 alpha. A reload time of 7.85 seconds. He's using standard HE at the moment to damage that KV-85, but the Skoda comes around the corner. And, well, the Cromwell on our team took out that KV-85. The VK going after our teammates. And the Skoda rams the AMX 12 ton. We fire a quick round in, but unfortunately we miss. That Skoda's repeatedly ramming the AMX 12 ton. He must be on reload. That's why he hasn't fired. And, well, we kill. Zephyr kills the Skoda 25, but he's been spotted. And it's an enemy tank. It's an IS. And he's got behind this pile of snow. Or is it rock as snow? Well, the IS managed to get around into him, but it actually hit the tracks. Would you believe it? So lucky. This is a tier 7 game, tier 5 arty and a tier 7. Can he kill that IS? He needs to quick, because that guy, if he's got the 122mm gun, could be a hell of a problem for him. Oh, he took down the camp with that shot. The IS didn't know he fired, but he has been spotted, so the enemy arty might be aiming in this direction. He gets one hit on the IS, he changes position, and the IS goes down. Now move away from that spot, because the enemy RT will be firing in this direction, more than likely. So, I reckon that shot from the IS probably blocked, oh, I would say maybe as much as 300 hit points. I didn't see how much was recorded, but it was certainly a lot, and probably more than the hit points of this vehicle. He missed his shot on the VK-3002D. Over on the other side in the city, we've got a Panzer 3K popped out to have a go at our T-34 shielded. And another enemy tank making its way up the trench system. It's a VK-3002D. Misses on that shot. He's headed towards Zephyr. So he's about to get attacked again. His teammates do not appear to be doing a very good job of keeping the cap clear of enemy tanks. And I'm expecting an enemy tank to pop out of that trench any second. And of course, the VK-3002D is the Daimler version of the Panther prototype. And here he is. Oh, and he missed it on his first shot. He needs to get behind cover. And the VK is coming. He's coming. He's turning this way. Yes, gets around into his side. Blocks the shot from the VK for 220. And now we get a second chance to take him out. And he does. With a shotgun. So how many shotguns has he done now? That must be at least four shotguns he's done. Or three shotguns at least. Well, there's only four enemy tanks left now. Only four. And he was firing now one. Oh, it just hits him with a blind shot. There's an enemy tank sitting behind that bush and he just struck him. And he must have pulled away because that shot missed. He's marked the spot to let his teammates know. I think it might be the tank destroyer. It could be a challenger. I think it was a challenger. Oh, yes, it is. There he is. He's pulled back. He probably won't pull very far. And Zephyr can keep his aim on him. Rounds out. If he stays there, he's going to take the round. Oh, and he moved. He moved. He's gone back to the bush. He's gone back to the bush. You're firing at the spot, and he's gone back to the bush, and he just took out our KV-1S. He's pulled into that corner, which makes it difficult to hit him, but he left himself a bit exposed. Oh! Kill shot! What a shot! Over the buildings, into the corner. The narrowest of aims went onto the engine deck and took out the Challenger. That's a hell of a kill. That's three kills now for Zephyr. T-52, the last remaining light tank on the enemy team. He's dialing in, making it accurate. Rounds out. Long flight time for the shell, but the Chi-Re gets the kill. But there's another enemy tank up there. It's a Churchill, and he just killed our giant Yag Panther. We fire around it. Near miss on the Cromwell. It's not Churchill, Cromwell, sorry. Now, the enemy Artie's been spotted. It's a gorilla. He's moved up to that bush. Dial in. Get an accurate shot. He fires. Unfortunately, it's going to miss the target. The gorilla's moved. He's changed position. He's stopped to shoot. He's 15 centimeter. Zephyr fires. Long range shot over the battlefield. Just narrowly misses the gorilla. He's going to have another go. Rounds out. This time he should get it. Oh, it knocks the building down instead. And the gorilla goes down to the 40 TP, and that ends the battle. That was pretty much a case of repel all borders. Those enemies were determined to kill him, and several of them, well, tried and failed. Let's have a look at the end of battle stats. It's an ace tank for Zephyr in the 105 Lerf H18B2. It gets so much easier to do an ace tanker when you get a tier 7 game. But of course, you meet tier 7 opponents, and they can be pretty deadly. And this was his first ace tanker in the 105 Lerf H18B2. He also managed to get a Bruiser Medal for getting at least 5 critical hits. He got 10, and he did end up with a Starks Medal as well. He actually blocked sufficient damage to more than his two-thirds of his hit points, got at least 2 kills, and survived the battle to earn the medal. And well done indeed. Let's have a look at team score and see. Oh, his win 8 first was 5,843, which is Super Unicum standard. So let's have a look at team score. Well, he was actually second on his team, but fourth overall on damage. The high scorer was, in fact, that challenger, the one he killed with a fantastic shot. 2,265 hit points goes to that player. 2,103 goes to the Cromwell, who managed to pick up the high caliber. So I suspect that the challenger actually did do some damage to one of his own teammates, and that left the high caliber to go to the Cromwell instead. The next highest scorer was the Tiger 1 with 1,927, and then Zephyr with 1,866. When it came to kills, it was the Cromwell. 4 kills to him. He managed to get a high caliber. And then 3 kills to the Tiger 1 and Zephyr and the Chi-Re. And when it came to base XP, it was Zephyr. 959 in this one, because he was tier 5, he was earning extra XP more than the others. The Tiger 1's the tier 7 tank, so he only earned 913, and the Chi-Re only got 693. He fired 33 rounds in that game, got 12 direct hits and 3 penetration, 16 splash. Damage of 1,866 hit points, of which 1,554 were at more than 300 meters. Just goes to show it's over 100 hit points that he did at close range. And he received 3 hits, only one of which was penetration. That was from the VK. and two which were non-penetrations, one from the VK and one from the IS. And he blocked damage of 220 hit points of damage altogether. And that's definitely more than two-thirds of his hit points. Six enemy vehicles damage, three killed, and 293 hit points of damage assistance. And he managed to get seven defense points when he killed or hit one of the enemy tanks when he was in the cap. On a premium count, he earned 45,756 credits, got 22,878 credits from the personal reserve bonus, and 17,387 from Holy Ops. Total was 86,021, and after repair and ammunition resupply, took away 80,981 credits. He got three bonds for the medal, Stark's medal, and 1,438 XP, 2,878 for Holy Ops, 576 because this is a premium vehicle, took away 4,892 experience points altogether. What a great game there. And that lob shot, as he says, one nice lob shot. The shot on that Challenger was amazing. It was such the narrowest of aims to get it into that little corner. And the Challenger moved out of the corner and then moved straight back into it again. And that's when the shell arrived. And oh, wow, that was a good kill because that was the best player on the enemy team. And you just took him out with an impossible shot. So congratulations to Zefner. Well done on your first Ace Tanker and your Starks medal. And if you enjoyed this replay, please give this video a like and do subscribe to our channel. And thank you for watching.